need that!
Very well.
I'll handle it.
Okay.
Right.
I'll handle this.
I'll handle it. Target locked.
I'll handle this.
Be gone. Ha! It's my turn. How about this?
It's my turn.
I'll handle this.
My turn.
It's my turn. That takes care of them. Great!
Okay.
Target locked.
I'll handle this.
Be gone! Ha!
Right!
Okay! Yes! Yeah.
I'll handle it.
Hostiles neutralized. Guess we're safe.
Treasure chest.
Advantage is ours. Let's finish it. Okay. Target locked.
My turn.
Be gone. Ha!
Leave it to me.
Okay. Done. But we can't relax yet.
Now's our chance.
I'll handle it.
Here.
My turn.
Be gone. Ha!
Leave it to me.
My turn. Target locked. Okay. Yeah.
My turn.
Be gone.
How pathetic.
I did it!
That should suffice.
Dangerous foe. Stay on guard. Now's our chance!
I'll handle it. Arcus, activate.
Very well.
Right!
My turn.
I'll handle it. Here we go. Yeah.
It's my turn. How about this?
It's my turn. Yes! This is it!
Gotcha!
I'll handle it.
Very well.
My turn. Yeah! Yeah!
Right!
I'll handle this.
Okay. Yeah! Yeah! Let's keep going! Done. I feel like I'm growing stronger. Advantage is ours. Let's finish him. Okay.
Leave it to me.
Okay. Arcus, activate. Yeah.
I'll handle this.
Be gone! Ha!
Ha. Done. But we can't relax yet.
Enormous. Stay on guard. Let's get this over with.
Okay. There we go. Silky dance! That's that.
Very well.
Leave it to me.
Yeah. Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. There you go.
Leave it to me.
Hang in there, everyone.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. I'll handle this.
Arcus, activate!
Shouldn't have bothered.
My turn. Arcus, activate.
I was careless.
Thank you very much. It's my turn. Arcus, activate. Now.
Thanks.
It's my turn.
Handle this.
Arcus, activate.
Sorry, everyone. Careless.
Should have fought. Right! It might be wise to retreat. You won't be so lucky next time!
Bye.
Okay.
Right! I've got this! Safe for now. Let's get him! Here we go!
My turn.
My turn.
Be gone!
Leave it to me!
You expect it to go.
Advantage is ours. Let's finish it.
Here we go.
Okay.
I'll handle this.
Be gone! Ha!
Leave it to me!
Okay.
Okay, it's safe for now.
Advantage is ours. Let's finish him.
Go! There! Now's our chance! Gotcha!
I'll handle it.
I'll handle this.
Be gone!
It's my turn!
Eat that!
My turn. Done. But we can't relax yet. We're finally back.
My feet are killing me.
Thank you.
Can't get to sleep?
I could ask you the same. You aren't going to tell me the bed's too hard for you, are you?
I wouldn't dream of it. I've never slept in a bed this high class in my life. Not even back at home.
And yet you're the son of Baron Schwarzer. You've not lived the life one might expect of a boy from a noble family.
Yeah, that's just how my dad is. A lord should live like his people, not above them. That's how he always put it.
I see. It sounds as though you have a good family.
Yeah, I'm very thankful for my upbringing.
Aren't you going to ask? I assumed you'd be curious about that brief exchange with my father earlier.
I wasn't really sure you'd want me to bring that up. You obviously get along really well with your brother, but I didn't get that same sense with the Duke. Has he always been like that?
As far back as I can remember. I suppose he just has little respect for a son born to a commoner.
What?
My brother and I have different mothers. He was born of my father's legal wife, a noble who still lives to this day. My own mother, however, was a commoner, and she passed away 8 years ago. In other words, I am his bastard son.
I had no idea. So, was that chef we met earlier?
He's my uncle, on my mother's side. Perhaps that's why he's always been so good to me. Or perhaps he's simply compelled to treat me as I deserve to be treated, being the son of the Duke.
No, that can't be. I don't blame you for being a little cynical, but there's no need to be quite so hard on yourself.
I suppose you're right.
I'm sure you have your differences. But you do get along with your brother, right?
You could say that. He's treated me well ever since I was taken in 8 years ago. He was the one who taught me my swordsmanship, and who trained me in the ways of court etiquette.
I knew it.
Pardon?
There's just something honest, I guess you could say, about the way you fight. It shows that whoever taught you was someone you really trusted. When we first met him this afternoon, I had a hunch he might have been the one. What's wrong?
Nothing at all. You just keep reminding me how unlike a noble you truly are.
I get that a lot.
Is your injury from this afternoon on the mend?
It's fine, honestly. There's no pain, and the wound's closed up like it was never there. I'll have to be sure to thank Emma's grandmother for her help someday.
That's good to hear. Still, from where I stand, you are something of a danger to yourself.
I am?
On the day of the entrance ceremony, when the trapdoor opened beneath us, you acted instantly to protect Elisa. It wasn't even a moment's hesitation.
Ah.
In most cases, one would reflexively act to protect himself. It's part of man's natural survival instinct. Yet you put another before yourself, not even pausing to question the validity of that decision. And you did exactly the same thing with us today. I'm sure most people would see that as an act of selflessness and sing your praises for it. But to me, it comes across as abnormal, perhaps even twisted.
I don't know how to respond to that. I wasn't expecting you to see through me quite so clearly.
Well, I owed you as much for having seen through me first. Still, the point stands. You need to be more cognizant of the effects your actions have on those around you. If not for your health and for your reputation? That selflessness of yours can just as easily be perceived as arrogance, after all.
I know it can. And you're not the first person to tell me that. What's the point in saving others if you can't spare even a moment to save yourself? That's what my old master always used to say to me.
Was it now? I suppose we both have some things we need to work through.
Yeah, but for now, we need to get a good night's sleep. If we stay up too late tonight, we're going to be dead to the world tomorrow, and that wouldn't be fair to the others.
I agree, wouldn't be fair. To the girls, at least. I'd hate to be so tired as to limit my potential.
Hear, hear. Good night, Eustace.
Pleasant dreams.
Up in the world. I've got a little reward here for you. Keep up the good work.
Eustace Alborea.
What is it, Machius Regnitz?
I will accept no more failures. Today, we will form a combat link.
What?
As much as I may dislike you, I'm ashamed that we were unable to do what every other member of our class has accomplished. Today's monster extermination request seems as good a chance as any to make up for yesterday's failure. What did you say?
You really are simple-minded, aren't you? I suppose you overheard our conversation last night and feel some kind of affinity toward me now?
Nonsense! I did no such thing! I was fast asleep while you yammered on about your family and Reen and...
Machius.
That's pretty conclusive.
Very well. I accept. I'll be happy to show you what a proper combat link looks like.
We'll see about that. Fortunately, I have more than enough generosity of spirit to endure being paired with an arrogant noble like you.
Maybe today's field study will go more smoothly than yesterday's after all.
Lord Eustace.
Arno? What brings you here? I would have expected you to be at my father's side.
I'm terribly sorry I could not greet you upon your arrival yesterday. However, I have come today in the capacity of an escort.
An escort? To where? I'm sure you must be aware that I returned to Bereahard purely as part of a field study for my academy work.
But of course. However, His Grace has directly requested that I escort you to the mansion. So I would be most appreciative if you'd accompany me without delay.
Father? He showed no signs of desiring my company when we spoke yesterday.
I am in no position to question or oppose his orders, merely to obey them. I'm sure you understand. Though while I hesitate to speculate, I do wonder if His Excellency may feel some regret regarding his demeanor yesterday.
But...
Go with him. We can attempt to form a combat link another time.
We'll be able to handle the morning's tasks just fine on our own. Don't worry about us.
Huh. You've come all the way back to your hometown. It would be a shame not to visit with your family, right?
Agreed.
Are you certain? Very well. I'll return this afternoon. And though I will worry as to how you'll fare without me, I know you'll at least give it your best, for what that's worth.
Of course we will.
All right. Let's meet back in the hotel lobby around noon. If something comes up, just leave a message at the front desk.
Understood. Lead the way, Arno.
Gladly, sir. Please excuse us.
Well, let's get started. We wouldn't want to give Eustace any further reason to worry, now would we?
Huh, certainly not. Still...
What? What is it? If you have something to say, just say it.
Oh, it's nothing. Nothing at all.
She's probably thinking, the worst is over, and it's all thanks to your eavesdropping.
Good boy.
Stop that! Stop looking at me like I'm some hapless babe! Rain, you do know I still haven't completely forgiven you for lying, don't you?
Are you still hung up on that?
And Emma, I hope you're ready to score second on our midterms because I'm not about to lose to you again! But don't even think about giving those exams any less than your very best. I intend to best you when you're in top form!
You will?
And as for you, Fee, I've been wanting to say this for a long time now. Sleeping in class is an affront to our education! You need to start treating classes more seriously. Listen, take proper notes, raise your hand now and then, and stop covering your ears when I'm talking to you!
I can't hear you.
Anyway, we've got a lot to do, so how about we get to it?
Right.
Thank you.